안녕하세요. 저는 예수님입니다. Just kidding. K-Lab. 반갑습니다. Where have I been? Just recently, I went to my hometown, America, Louisiana. We just ate food and hung out with family. Honestly, my wife was very bored. She said, America is really boring. Today, I'm going to talk about things that I don't do in Korea anymore, but I do in America when I go back and visit. So when I went to America, I noticed that this was kind of a thing, is that people just show up to your house, like family, friends, your mom's friends, everyone just shows up to your house. Like in Korea, if I want to go and visit my mother-in-law, we call and contact, hey, what are you doing? Let's meet up at this time. But in America, it's not like that. Like people just show up to your house. So my wife was meeting all kind of new people and she said, I need a break. Can we please not meet anyone new today? I was like, okay, I promise you. And right after I promised her, someone knocked on the door and walked in. I was like, I didn't know. So people just show up to your house. Like, because it's such like, that's all you can do in small cities is hang out. People just show up and hang out with you. So that's one thing that's much different than living in Korea. Yeah, sometimes I would show up to like friends' house or family friends, just knock on the door. Because in America, you have this thing like you say, our door is always open. And that means if you want to come, you can come. So people just come uninvited, just show up, and it can be crazy sometimes. You just want to rest and you're not going to rest. In Korea, you contact them, you call or text, and you make an arrangement. You put it in your calendar. Like my wife always like 3 weeks ahead, she'll say, hey, my friends want to come over. Can we do it? 3 weeks later, I'm like, sure, that's far away, but okay. They overplan things. Another thing that they do in America that they don't do here is tipping. So it's traditional to give like 10% or 15% of your bill. So if you pay $20 for your bill, you should give a tip of at least $2. But sometimes you go eat, it's $100, you give a tip of $15 if it's 15%. So eating out in America is more expensive than Korea, because Korea, you just go, if it's 7,000 won, you pay 7,000 won, that's all. But in America, if you go, I like to tip a little better because I was a waiter before. And waiters in America get paid maybe $2.50, 2,500 won per hour. So tip is their money. So that's why tipping is a thing. They don't get paid a lot, so you tip them. In Korea, I think if you're a waiter, it's just minimum wage, right? Or whatever the company does. So tipping was not fun when I went home because it's just extra money. It's like a weird feeling since I've been living in Korea so long. When I go home, everyone wears shoes inside. Every room, you walk around with your shoes. Like I said before, you don't wear your shoes on the furniture. But people walk around with their shoes. And when I went home, I always took off my shoes at the front door because it's so much cleaner to do. But in America, a lot of people have like wood floors, so it's not as bad. They just walk around. But yeah, wearing shoes inside was something that I did in America before. When I went home, I tried not to do it because I like how clean it is without shoes. My family was okay. My family really appreciates like the Asian way of doing it. Japan is the same way. So when they visited Korea and Japan, they were really happy with how inside it was so clean. Actually, my dad has some slippers that he wears inside now, so he doesn't really walk around with his shoes anymore. So it kind of like, when I go home, it like rubs off on them. They want to do kind of our way. It's more clean. Another thing I noticed was in America, sometimes we go outside without shoes. So we can just go walk outside to get the mail or go get something out of our car. Even just walk in the backyard. We have yards. So you walk outside barefoot and you have your feet on the soil. Your feet are touching the grass and it feels like you're connected to the earth. When you're in Seoul, you always wear shoes outside. Well, sometimes you have like flip-flop slippers in the summer, but you don't really walk around barefooted. But I always did in the summer. I was just walking around outside, no shoes. I liked it, just hanging out in the backyard. So that's something I noticed. Oh, I never did that in Seoul, walked around without shoes. Yeah, I think it's strange. Well, I think Americans really don't like taking off and putting their shoes on. So if they see, I need to go outside to get something really quick, they just say, oh, I'll just leave my shoes off if they're already off. So if your shoes are off, you just go outside with your shoes off. If your shoes are on, you go outside with your shoes on and you stay inside with your shoes on. I think it's just like kind of, we're lazy in America with our shoes. We just don't want to take them off or put them on. So one thing that I really enjoyed when I went back home was driving. There was no traffic because I live in a smaller city. So I could just cruise down the highway, cruise, and it's stress-free driving. I can drive. But in Korea, I don't drive. I drove one time and that was so crazy because Seoul has so many people and there's so much traffic and there's big highways, like maybe 5 lanes of so much traffic, and it's pretty stressful to drive in Seoul. So most people around my age take public transportation. I really enjoy public transportation, but when I was back home, I liked driving. It felt like I was in control. Even my wife looked at me and she was like, cool, you can drive. Like, you know, people look like, you watch Ryan Gosling movie and he's driving. That's how I felt. I was driving, I looked over, wind was blowing in my hair, and she was like, all right. So today I talked about things that I don't do in Korea, but I still do when I go back to America. If you like this video, please leave a comment and some likes and subscribe to the channel. I'll see you next time. Peace. Woo-hoo.